What's up, guys? Everyday Tools here, back again with another video. Today we got my uncle here, and we're gonna be working on the Craftsman toolbox. So as you guys saw in the last video, we haven't been doing much progress on it, but now we're really gonna get started on it. We got the Bondo ready, we've taken all the rusts off. My uncle cut up some parts from an aluminum can so we can get this done, and I'll just show you what we started working on here. So we have the can parts from Diet Pepsi and Coca-Cola. So those are gonna block off that hole there. And then we're going to use the Bondo on the other side and hold it all together. So I'm going to move you guys up to the top so you can get a better view, and let's get through this. Alright guys, so we're back. So this is where the hole is right here. I'll just zoom into that. So this is what we're going to be repairing. So this is the before shot, so if you pause the video right here, this is what it looks like before we started doing anything on it. We got most of the rust removed, all the paint removed from the area, and then the same thing on the other side. We got the paint removed, we got the rust removed, and we smoothed it out with the angle grinder and just took all the rust spots off to make it a smooth work area. Alright guys, so this is the Bondo kit that I'm going to be using today. It's a fiberglass repair kit from Walmart. It was $17.99. It comes with the fiberglass resin, comes with the fiberglass cloth, a hardener, a small spreader like this, and a little mixing pan, but it's really flimsy. It's kind of just what the stuff came in. So this is what we're gonna be using. And the sandpaper I use is just regular 40 grit, 80 grit, just the whole process. And we're just gonna get to it, start with the metal, and then put some Bondo on top of it, mix it all up, put the hardener on, and we're gonna show you all those steps. All right, so right now we're just prepping the surface with some soapy water here. It says Glass Plus on it, but it's just water and soap. And we're just gonna remove all the dirt particles and the rust, and then we're gonna let it dry. Probably blow it off with the air compressor, just get all the wet particles off of it, just so it'll be dry and prep for the Bondo to go on there, and then we'll just get to the next step. All right guys, so we got the air compressor nozzle here. We're just gonna be blowing this off, just get all the particles out and the dust. All right, so we got these layers spread out here. So this is the first layer. We're gonna put that there, and then you have this little under layer just to cover up some of the other holes. We're gonna be putting Bondo directly on top of this. We're gonna mix the Bondo on this piece of scrap wood I have here.
It's a mistake.
Yeah, they gave us this in the package, but it's obviously not suitable for use.
Yeah.
So we're gonna take this and the hardener, if it would focus, there we go. And the hardener, mix it together, and then we'll show you how we're gonna put this on. So this is obviously, you know, a homemade trick that we're trying to figure out here. Instead of using the fiberglass cloth, we're gonna try to use the aluminum can, and hopefully it works out better than we expect. All right, so we got a bit of a change of plans here. So I was reading the fiberglass kit, and we're actually not gonna use the metal for this. So we're just gonna patch the hole, and then later on we're gonna get our Bondo filler and just use the body filler to fill in the hole on the other side. So That'll be in this video, a little bit later on in the video, but for now we're just going to be doing the patch, and then we'll show you later on how we're going to fill it all in with the Bondo filler that we're going to get from Walmart. Alright, now that we found scissors that actually cut, we're just going to cut this around, get all the loose ends off of it, and just make the piece so that it'll fit across our hole and make sure that it's all filled, just so the patch is there and we can set this up for the Bondo body filler. So we just cut the patch to size, we got it all trimmed up. My uncle cut off all the ends and everything and used a razor blade and some scissors just to trim it up. We had the China scissors from Harbor Freight and the American box cutter from Stanley, so that worked well. And now we're just going to be laying this down, putting some of the Bondo adhesive onto it just to harden it up, and then showing you our next step and how it's all going to work out. So now we're just spreading this out on here, and we're going to be putting it onto the actual metal itself and just spread it out with the paintbrush just to get our first layer on. And then we're going to directly put our layer of fiberglass cloth right on top of it. And once that's on there, we're just going to keep layering, and We'll just repeat the steps one by one, and until you have enough layers, two or three layers should be good, and then your hole will be repaired, and we're gonna show you those steps, and then we're gonna have that part with the body filler a little bit later on. All right, so now we're gonna apply our fiberglass cloth directly onto the fiberglass resin. Push it down so you get even placement on all spots. So then you use your paintbrush to get that down. You should really wear gloves when you're doing this, but I'm sick of wearing gloves. We're just gonna keep pushing this down and add some more filler on top of it, or some more resin, and we'll do another layer, and then later on we're gonna be putting the filler on top of this. All right, so we got the resin on top of the cloth, as you can see right here, and it barely looks like it's even there. It's almost transparent at this point. We're gonna be adding another layer on top and putting more resin on. All right, so we got my uncle here. He's doing the brushwork on the fiberglass resin. We're just spreading more out. We got our second layer on there. We didn't show that on the video, but we're just gonna keep putting more layers on it till we think it's right amount. And then later on, we're gonna have the Bondo body filler just to clear up the hole on top. And it's gonna look as good as new once we're done painting and everything. Another layer of fiberglass cloth on top, and we're just spreading more resin just to get this all cleaned up, and it's gonna look all smooth once we're done. Okay, so we just finished up the fiberglass resin. We put four layers on. They got smaller as we went through because we were getting closer to the hole, and this is what it looks like right now. We have all the resin on top, we have the sheets, and now on top the hole is patched, and then tomorrow we're gonna get to our Bondo. But for you guys, it'll be today, and it'll be in the same video. And we're just gonna get to that, and then once this all dries up, tomorrow morning, we'll just get right on it and pick up our Bondo body filler, and then just start patching the hole. And hopefully it looks really good, and we'll be able to be proud of what we did. All right, so it's the next day. We got our Bondo body filler here. Just pick this up from Walmart for about $8. We have our piece that we're gonna be spreading it on. So we're gonna put some of this out on the piece of wood here and take some of the cream hardener that came with it, put one line down the middle of it, mix it up, and then we're gonna fill the hole. It hardened up a lot overnight, as you can see, and we'll show the inside. It's all hard and solid. So once we get this all sanded down, we'll be able to do the top and bottom, and it'll look all good.
I'm gonna get a fair amount.
Yeah. Let me take the cream hardener here, open that up, and then put just one line down the middle. It should be a fair amount. And then we're gonna take our spreader, this guy right here, and then spread it out, and then just keep mixing it back and forth until you get it all mixed up. All right, so we got it all mixed up, and now we're just gonna start applying it to the toolbox. So we're gonna take our small spreader and take some of the Bondo off the platter here, and actually scrape it right off. So you wanna mix it until you don't see any orange left. So once all the orange is gone, that means the hardener is mixed well, and you want to flatten it out when you're done mixing it so you get all the air bubbles out. So we're going to take some and just put it on the toolbox, start spraying it out. And it dries pretty quickly, so you want to make sure you get it in the spot that you need it, and then you can just keep adding layers. Alright, so we got our first layer of Bondo on there. We spread it out, and we're gonna wait 20 to 30 minutes for it to dry, and then hit it with some 80 grit just to get all the imperfections out, do another layer, and then just keep doing that until we think what we have here is good. Alright guys, we're back. So we finished our first layer of Bondo. We used the sander, the orbital sander, and some sandpaper, 80 grit, just to get it all smoothed out. And on the inside, it's still the same, but We're focusing on the top right now. We're just going to get all these imperfections out, do another layer, fill up some of these holes. You can see there's still some pretty large gaps. Like right there is a gap. Over here it's a little bit of a bump, and we're just going to work on getting all that out. And then we'll show you the next clip, and we're just going to keep going at this. But after this, obviously, we're going to be doing painting and everything. All right, so we finished up. We sanded all the Bondo down with 150 grit sandpaper. We used the sander over there. We also used some regular sandpaper. We used a sanding block. My uncle did all the drawers with the Bondo. So you can see down there, it's all the little pitted holes are filled up. Down there, we got it filled up. There's a little bit of rust. We had to fill that, sand it down. Inside, we're just going to keep it like that because it would be way too much work to get all that sanded down. It wouldn't look good anyway. So we're going to keep it like that for now. And once we paint it, it'll disappear. On the side, we got a little bit of Bondo. And now we're just going to be getting ready to paint it. Clean it up with some shop towels. Get all the hard Bondo off. All the bad spots that hardened up that didn't do well. We're going to get all those spots off. This is all smooth now. It's solid. The hole is filled. It's all solid in there. And this is stuff we use. We use the body filler. We use the fiberglass repair kit. We use the wire wheel. We use HyperTuff. The sander over there. And that's how we did all of it. And we got the batteries charging over there after using the wire wheel. So now we're just going to take out these liners, the draw liners, the bearings, and we're going to lube them up with some silicone lubricant. We're going to clean up all in there, and then we're going to get ready to paint it. We got the whole thing painted. It looks a lot different, but you can see we painted the handles here. We painted them silver. We got all this. This is still original, just the metal. We taped it off and just painted around it. We didn't get much footage of the painting process, but we got a little bit for you to see. Inside, we still have to do a little bit of work, but for now, we're gonna paint that all red and sand it down a little bit. This is gonna be hard to get out of here, so we're just gonna leave that probably. And you can see the drawers, they're all done here. They're all repainted. We're going to be putting draw liners in it. One of my future videos, you'll see how it looks and everything. And it'll be part of the shop. So things are a lot better. We cleaned up the runners on the side. Now we just have to oil them. But it looks a lot better. It works great and just does what it needs to do. It's a nice toolbox. So we got the whole thing repainted. Even the bottom, you know, you remember that huge hole right there. You can't even notice that there was anything there. It's just solid now. Looks a lot better. Yeah.
Nice. All right, let's go wash up.
All right.